Hey guys, welcome back. In this lecture, I will talk about list transformation, the process of going through the list content and transforming it to create another list that would be a variation of the original list. This is going to be a very common operation and that is used in quite a lot of different applications, either at a very low algorithmic processing level, or sometimes you just need to do that transformation at a high level. For instance, let's say you have a list where you have a bunch of different timestamps. Let's say it's just a collection of different dates and times recorded in a numeric format where it's the number of milliseconds. One of the transformations that could happen where you need to transform it to a more readable format. So that would be a good example of transformation. No matter what the transformation is, of course, the logic will vary. There's just one block that allows you to perform such transformation. That block is located in the lists category. Scroll all the way to the bottom and you will see this map items in list block. And this is the block that is responsible for providing you the option for value transformation. Just like with all other examples and experiments that we had, I'm going to bring in the print block, connect the map items block to it, and very similarly as with sorting and filtering, this block accepts list as the input parameter. I will use my variable, but in the actual applications, it can be just anything that returns a list. In fact, you could have, you know, sorting block that returns a list that is feeding into filtering, and filtering could be feeding into map. Completely up to you. As long as the input type is list, this block will work. So in here, the concept of applying transformation is going to be very similar as with, for instance, filtering. And what happens is, for the list that is fed into the map items block, an iterator is created. So it's going to iterate over the contents of that list. And then with every single step of that iterator, the item variable, which is the default variable that is created for this, and you can change it to other variables, the item variable will contain one specific value. So in this case, in some, using the rainbow variable that contains this list, the first iteration will contain the value of red. Second one, it's going to be the value of orange. And this way it will go through all of them, giving you a chance to transform that value any way you want to. The return connector is used to actually return back the value in the transformed fashion. And the most basic example that I can think of here is transforming this list where I change each individual value to the uppercase version of it. In this case, it can be very simple where I essentially return the value converted to uppercase. And as you can see, if I go to text and then select this to uppercase and then connect item to the uppercase, let me go to variables, then that's all it will take to create a new list where every single value is converted to uppercase. I will run this page and you'll be able to see the created list. So the created list, as you can see, has exactly the same values. They are positioned exactly the same way as the original list, but everything is an uppercase. This is a very simple transformation. For more complex ones, you can actually put that logic inside of this block and transform it and then arrive at the actual transformed value and then simply return it. So for instance, let's say that for the values that's where the length of it, let's say, is less than 4, equals or less than 4, let's just, you know, decorate it somehow. I know, silly example, but I just want to demonstrate how you put additional logic inside of this map items and list. So in here, let's first of all determine if it is less than 4. First of all, we get the length of and connect variable item. So that will return the length of it. Then in the logic, we use this block for the comparison. So in here, we're going to be checking if it is less than or equal, and then add 4 as the number. And also add the actual if statement inside of this already. And this is going to be our condition. So if the length of item is less than or equal 4, let's modify this item somehow. And we will modify that item by doing the following. We'll use the create text, and in here with this text, let's reuse one of these blocks. Let's say that we will add kind of this thing, and then the actual item will be appended to it. Grab the variable item, and then let's also do the closing dashes like this. All right, so this will be the modified value of the item. And the question is, where should it be stored? Well, it can be stored in the item itself, because what's going to happen is anything inside of here is going to run all the logic for any given item. And then the item itself will be returning it back modified to uppercase. So what we can do is in the variables, we can actually do set item to this value. So as you can see, we check if the length is less than or equal 4, then we do this kind of transformation, and then we take this item, whatever it is, it could be, you know, dashes, red dashes, or it could be just green. Whatever it is, it will be converted to uppercase. Let's run it. And as you can see, right here we have value red with dashes, because this is the actual result. And then the value of blue is with dashes, only because red and blue are less than or equals 4, the length of that value. All other values are greater than 4. So that's, there you have it. So the concept of mapping or transforming will be the same. Iterating through, giving you a chance to transform each and every value. Inside of this, you can use functions, you can use anything you need. So everything that you have learned so far is directly applicable. And then just return the item that you would need to appear in the final list. That's the transformation. Very simple, but extremely powerful concept. Once we start looking into objects, you will see that this particular block will become especially useful, because there will be a lot of use cases when we will need to do the transformations of objects in lists. But that's coming soon. Thank you for watching this video, guys. As always, happy Codeless coding.